And next, I'm going to ask Linda Umberger to come up and speak to us. So, Linda?
Thank you. It is a privilege to be here. I live in Dawson County, which isn't too far away, and enjoy the drive over and love coming in and seeing the flags and everything as I came down Main Street crossing over the highway. And y'all are great. I mean, the turnout here is phenomenal, and I congratulate you for getting up on a rainy morning, being active, and being part, and being what is the Republican Party. I had an experience in November of 1976 where my dad woke me up and said, "Get dressed, there's something important going on." We did not vote for Jimmy Carter, but this is a historic moment as a Georgian, that the first Georgian has just been elected President of the United States. And while I was there and listening and standing in the crowd, it became apparent to me that whatever party these people were, I was not. And that was my moment of conversion to become a Republican. And ever since then, and because of my parents and the values they instilled in me, I have been a Republican. And what does that mean? It means that I respect the Constitution, I respect life, I'm for limited government, and I'm for personal responsibility. And when we look at where we are as a nation, all that is being lost. And when I continue with my life and what the Lord has blessed me with, that I had the opportunity to work in the Reagan White House and intern, and then go on to be a mom of what I consider to be the most four greatest kids in the world. And I got to homeschool them. And what I see going on is that our economy, restrictions, government regulations, Obamacare, the cost of everything, are preventing parents from being able to impact the lives of their children. Why? Because they are so busy working just to pay the light bill, just to pay insurance. Oh, and that cell phone bill, which is kind of expensive. But anyway, moving right along. When you look at what's at stake and the role of the RNC, and yes, I do want to congratulate the RNC, because under Reince Priebus, first quarter, they had a record-breaking fundraising, even in a presidential race, which is good because we need this money going into November. Because I don't know about you, but there is no doubt in my mind that we cannot have Hillary Clinton as a president, because when you look at bathrooms, when you look at our religious liberties, when you look at everything, all that will be lost under President Clinton. And the fact that on September 11th of 2012, the current administration and Hillary Clinton allowed our ambassador and our servicemen to totally be abandoned by our nation. There should be no doubt in anyone's mind here today that you need to vote, and you need to vote for the Republican nominee, who it looks like it's going to be Donald Trump, and you need to do that enthusiastically. And I'd also like to share with you, I'm very excited that we've been able to get Tig, who is one of the authors of 13 Hours, and he will be at the convention on Friday, June 3rd, signing books and speaking, and we'll also be having a viewing of 13 Hours, so I'd like to invite you to come and see that and meet him, and to share with your friends and family that at the end of the day, that moment on September 11th, 2012 is real, crystal clear. There is no doubt of who they need to be voting for this November. Which, when you look at what is the point of the RNC, the point of the RNC is that it is made up of three members from each state and each territory, making 168 members. Those 168 members help with fundraising, they help with the budget, they do rules, they do resolutions, and they also do site. So a lot of the things that are done as RNC members are very limited, but it's about amplifying, it's about getting Georgia to be the leader at the RNC and taking our Georgia values to the RNC to have impact. To have impact on what goes on at the national level. We are very blessed. Randy Evans has done a great job on the Rules Committee. Most people on the Rules Committee are attorneys. Linda Heron, who is our current National Committee Woman, has done a great job on the Budget Committee. I would like to continue with what she has established on the Budget Committee, because it's been my experience, usually whoever controls the purse strings and whoever is making decisions where the money's going has a lot of input. And when we look at what Maria pointed out, where the money's going, we need to do a better job messaging, we need to do a better job training young people, and oh, the most important thing, we need to do a better job coming to you all on the grassroots and saying, what do you need to be successful? I had the privilege of working on two presidential candidates' teams this cycle, and it was fascinating to me how different they were. One team came to me and said, Linda, what do you need to be successful? You know this area in South Carolina, what is it going to take? And it was that sort of attitude that made such a powerful difference. Because it's not someone up here saying, based on the data, you need to do this. You know your community. The RNC and some very intelligent geek sitting in an office does not know it like you do. So what do you need? How can we help you to level, to you know, uplift and utilize your network to turn out the vote? What do you need? So it's all about you. How do we get your voice heard? How do we get you empowered to do what you need to do to turn out the vote and turn our country around and bring it back to our values and what we value to hold on to it for our kids? I encourage you to go to lynda2016.gop, learn more about what we're doing, and join Team Linda. I'd love to have you. I ask for your vote. Also, some of you will have gotten in the mail this thing about Get Connected. It's a great new app that we're experimenting with because calling people on their landlines to go vote really isn't that effective. It's kind of annoying. So what about using their cell phones to connect with them? So I encourage you to go to your app store, download Blue Arc, and on Tuesday, when you go by your precinct, you'll probably get a message reminding you to vote with the hours of when the precinct is open and things like that. And it's just another avenue to increase voter contact that we're experimenting with. So thank you very much and keep up your great work.
Thank you.